The cicadas have already begun emerging across Chicago and throughout Illinois. And if you're wondering what to expect, we've got you covered today.
Yeah, Alan Lawrence, curator of entomology at the Peggy Notebaert Nature Museum, joins us now with everything you need to know. And we are like a 50-50 family here because I got a ton of them and she's got none.
Yeah, actually, yeah. So what is that? Because I'm in the city, we're not seeing them, and she's in the suburbs.
Yeah, they're pretty patchy in distribution. You're going to see fewer of them towards urban centers, so you'll have more in the suburbs and a lot more in forest preserves.
Okay. So does that mean we won't see them at all?
Probably, yeah. Now's the time where they're coming out, so if you don't see them within the next few days, you're probably clear for the month.
And I'm you keep talking about moving to the suburbs. You come to the city, girl.
I'm drowning in them. And it's funny because it was like I saw the holes for weeks before they came out.
Right. The little nymphs here.
Yeah, okay,
they
that's
will
the first
start
stage.
To poke out of the ground, just checking conditions, and crawl back in until the soil temperature really is warm enough. Mm-hmm. Has to get about 64 degrees Fahrenheit, 6 to 8 inches below ground.
Okay, and then you have the hole in there too. So does one come out a hole or 50 come out a hole?
Generally one per hole.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
All right, so we see the one you have here. Where did that one come from?
Yeah, so this one, a coworker brought in for me from Midlothian. I live in Rogers Park and I don't have any.
Okay, that's the Midlothian cicada.
And what phase is that cicada in? Like how many days has he been out?
So this is an adult. They've been out for just a few days now. So this is the end of their life cycle.
Yep.
Its job now is to start screaming, calling to attract a mate. Okay. And then once the females have mated, they'll lay their eggs in twigs and branches.
Oh, wow. He fell.
They're pretty chill, though. We didn't go very far. Yeah.
Well, that's the thing. My kids love playing with them, but I take my dog outside and I'm getting dive bombed by them. Like, because they're... And they're not like, I don't mean coming after me, but they keep hitting me the head.
Yeah, I mean, they are very docile, they're friendly, they come in peace. But if you live near a lot of trees and walk by them, you're a large object like a tree, they might bump into you.
Yeah. Okay, and we keep hearing about they shoot urine, that they dive you and just like, get you, I'm coming to get you. Is that true?
I haven't really experienced that. Don't worry about being drenched. Maybe if you're sitting underneath hundreds of them in one tree, you'll feel a little wetness.
Okay.
All right.
Okay, so we're, I'm probably... 6 days into their emergence. What are the next phases? So now they're sticking to the trees.
Yep.
Are they going to keep moving around? And when do they start making the noise?
Yeah, they'll start hanging out. It takes about 3 to 5 days for their cuticles, the exoskeleton, to fully harden after they come out. And that's when they can start singing.
Okay.
So pretty soon you should start to hear that. And they'll continue that for about a month, and then they expire and they die. So by the end of June, they should be wound down.
Okay. And so I see some of them in your box. They are so much bigger than this little guy right here. What's different about that one versus the one you're carrying here?
Yeah, so these big ones are tropical cicadas from... It's still here on my hand. We're all good.
She just freaked out.
But those are tropical cicadas. So this shows you how big they can get in some parts of the world.
Uh-huh.
Here, these dog day cicadas right in the center are the ones we hear and see every year.
Okay. That's
but this year, it's the periodical cicadas. They're smaller, black bodies, orange wings and legs, red eyes.
It's the red eyes.
Yeah, it's the eyes.
It's the red eyes. And we're so used to bugs being bothersome, so I think so many people like have this natural reaction to be like, ugh, but we're not going to do anything to us, to our plants, to our kids, to our pets.
Yeah, they're vegetarians. They don't cause very significant damage to any plants, except for maybe some very young trees if you just planted them within the last year or two. You can throw some netting over them.
We did that,
That's
too.
That's totally fine. But they're so docile. They're vegetarians. They won't bite. This is really just a great experience to get up close. They're huge. You can look at all the body parts of an insect and really just...
They don't move quick.
Yeah, they don't move very fast. They only fly about 50 meters away from where they emerge in their whole lifetime. So they stay kind of close.
Okay, so we know that everything in nature has a purpose. What is the purpose of the cicada?
Yeah, so I would just say its purpose is to live and continue its own life, but there are so many different ways that they interact with their environment. Mm-hmm. Their survival strategy is kind of so many will emerge that everything that can eat them will and will be full and very happy for that month. And then enough of these survive that the populations can continue. And then at the end of the month, when you have piles of their dead bodies, those will decompose and restore nutrients to the soil as one big sort of nutrient pulse.
Okay. Yeah, I was telling him that in the commercial break, we the first day they emerged, we had a million dead ones everywhere because all the animals were getting at them. Mm. For the frontliners were taking the brunt of the attacks.
And pets, if they do happen to eat one, are they okay?
Yep, that's okay. Cicadas are non-toxic. Yep. They are safe to eat for pets and humans. I would maybe not let your dog eat too many at once, or if you get an upset stomach, like eating too many treats.
Yeah, okay. I keep pulling Frankie away. I'm like, don't grab it. I don't want to fish it out of your mouth. All right, thank you so much. Yeah, I appreciate it. It's some good information to have. Check out the Peggy Notebaert Nature Museum over there on Cannon Drive. You can see the social media handles. Naturemuseum.org is the website.